Namaste, beautiful yogis. Today, this video is dedicated to the subject of self-love. I just shot a video on self-love and I went a little deeper with my thoughts about self-love, but on a more surface level about the body, which is a lot of young girls struggle with that. At the end of the video, I will show you one of my really imperfections, my saggy tummy skin, and will show you that I'm not ashamed of it. I will walk in a bathing suit because I don't want to feel shame. I don't want to feel shame of my body or of my imperfections. That's the bottom line. And stick to the end. But before that, good workout to take care of the external, which will take care of what's inside the external. All right. Love you.
And I have to share with you what supports my yoga practice. That is, again, as I've mentioned to you before, the native deodorants. I had to put them to the test after we moved to Austin, Texas. It's 100 degrees weather. And the native deodorants work really well in LA, but here it is so much more humid, it is hotter. And I had to put them to the test here, and guess what? Yep, they worked. I have done 2 massive walks after I placed the deodorant on. 2 massive walks, dripping sweat from the heat. 2 massive walks and a workout, and still no smell. They have new seasonal scents. Every season they come up with new scents that are amazing. I really, really love the coconut lime and lychee goji berry is very fruity. That's what I'm using right now. Strawberry rhubarb. They're all natural with probiotics added to them, baking soda, and that way we're not putting anything toxic in our body. Of course, everything gets absorbed into our body. They're very, very natural and very effective. There's finally a natural deodorant that is truly effective. A small company in San Francisco. If you want to support small business in USA, that's another benefit. And here is my partner's scent. Hibiscus mint. All right, and John is installing, not installing.
This is a very complex installation.
Hanging a little thing in the shower that will hold our shampoo and stuff. And Johnny,
yep.
You've been using the hibiscus mint native deodorant, which actually matches your shirt right now.
Uh-huh. I think it works really good.
Yeah, is it a good natural deodorant?
It's really good. It's most of the natural deodorants that I've ever tried, they don't work. I get body odor within half a day, and so This is the first one that really works.
All right, thank you.
Namaste, beautiful yogis. Today we are doing another 12 and a half minute workout. It is going to be 10 seconds of work, 40 seconds, 10 seconds of rest, sorry. 40 seconds of work, but it will feel kind of like 10 seconds of work. And we'll move as we go. Those are simple sessions, somewhat beginner friendly. Now I have to mention that you can make this video, if you're going to the selection under, you can make this video 75 at a 0.75 speed if you want to slow it down, if you're more of a beginner. And also I now have for download online my beginner course. So if you're a complete beginner, go to my course first, which is on my website. I'll put the link below, but just go to alikamenova.com, downloadable courses, and you'll find it in 3 parts. Do all 3 parts. Part 1 can be done in 1 month or in 3 months. You can repeat it for 3 months. Part 2 is the same. partly is the same, and you will be able to, first of all, be in very good shape, and second of all, do everything with understanding of alignment and just jump into the classes and understand them, be able to modify them, etc. So do that if you're a complete beginner. Otherwise, for beginners that have basic knowledge, these classes are good. We'll begin, make sure that you're warmed up. I'm beyond warmed up. I'm dripping sweat. These shorts are too much wear. But this is what I have right now because still not everything is unpacked. I'm trying to put furniture in this room so that it's less echoey. Hopefully the echo will go away in the next few videos, and we'll get started. 15 cycles, so 15 exercises. The first one will be cross lunge and squeezing the hips. So we're strengthening the hip, not just hip openers, but hip strengthening is so important. Cross lunge, keeping the knee back and open. Cross lunge and open. That's the first exercise.
Starting session.
Let's begin. 7, 6, 5. Cross back, squeeze. Cross back, squeeze. Cross back, squeeze. Opposite side.
Work.
Squeeze. Power the booty on the standing leg side. Rest. Next one is semi-plie and squeezing side to side. You can go a little deeper. White squat, semi-plie. Three lunge. So we're gonna step back, step across, step out. Rest. Listen to the voice. Opposite side. Step to the side. Step back.
Rest.
All right, plank. Plank time. Jump in, come up, jump back. Also known as burpee. Side plank with arm reach. So we're going to reach under, reach up. Opposite side. Yeah. in the quads.
Rest.
We're gonna walk. Now, in plie, walks, rest forward, walk back. Walk forward, walk back. Walk back. Maybe dance as you walk. As if you're doing wide-legged salsa. Plank. Tapping the opposite shoulder. Almost done. We'll finish in tabletop. It's a very important pose because it's one of the pulling movements, the opposite of pushing. It involves the pulling muscles, we're not pulling. Alright, from here we're gonna jump out, jump in, jump out, try to lift your hips, jump in, jump out. Jump in, jump out. Last exercise will be in tabletop. Let's go. We're going to be kicking the legs and pressing the opposite hamstrings. You can be on your heels here to engage the hamstrings a little more. Last exercise, so keep going. We're done. Yes, the native deodorant continues working. Oh, I'm drenched. I just shot a video on self-love, which I will upload either to my membership or on here, and I'll link it if it goes up before this video. Self-love, very important, very important subject. My opinion on self-love is very unconventional. It's very against the popular narrative right now. It's very against the kind of like the parenting social movement nowadays. In Social media, everything is being parroted. Do you hear things being repeated by everyone in the same kind of way? Like using the same sentences? Parroting. People don't use independent thinking, so important. If we were not exposed to teachers or caretakers as children who developed our independent thinking, we have to study it now so that we educate our children to be independent, non-conformist thinkers. As far as self-love goes, I will show you something physical which really has nothing to do with self-love. Your external has nothing to do. We take care of ourselves, we're supposed to love ourselves, we're supposed to like how we look, we're supposed to love who we are just as a given, just as a child loves themselves. And we're supposed to love ourselves because of our imperfections. They're part of the chaotic element in the universe, the feminine aspect of the universe. And I'll show you my tummy after pregnancy. That's not the only imperfect part of me. I have pretty much every part of me is imperfect, but I'm good with it. I like it because some things will improve and I'm all up for that. And some things won't and I don't care. It won't change how I feel about myself, because when I become dust, none of this will matter. While I'm not dust, I will care for it and I will like it. That's some of the self-love love. Talk, it went a little deeper than this. This is all kind of surface level. But let me show you my tummy, because it's still, the skin is very wrinkly if you do it a certain way, but that does not mean that I'm not going to love myself. It's still wrinkly. Of course, it was stretched up to here, it was big. It is wrinkly, and you don't see that in social media all the time. And you kind of think that if there is an imperfect part of you, supposedly you should change it, fix it, or improve, or kind of dislike it. No, you're supposed to love it because really, it doesn't matter. And it has been improving, it was terrible in the beginning, obviously. So it may even disappear, I don't care. If it disappears, obviously I'll like it. But if it doesn't, it won't change how much I like. It, in the beginning, when I used to do plank, a lot of the tissue will hang, and now you can see it's all pulled back in. So things do improve with yoga and breathing and self-acceptance. But if they don't, it is good. It's all good. Namaste.